I like to move a little bit around. Can everybody hear me correctly? Hello. I want to thank the Mall of Wall, the association, for allowing me to speak here tonight. We're thankful for going to the church over there on the side. We are at Montclair School. I want to first say thank you. My name is Noel DeVault. For people who don't know me, I'm the city councilor at large. I previously was on the school committee. I'll talk a little bit about my background. Grew up in Quincy Point area of the city, graduated Quincy High School in 1993, educated through the Quincy Public Schools, furthered my education at UMass Boston, right across the way here. Started off in politics as a community activist here in the city. Was the Ward 2 Civic Association president, very similar to the presidency here. Also coached Quincy Point Panthers youth football in my seventh season doing that. Very important to mentor the children of our city, as well as being involved with the Sons of the American Legion, Marset Post 294. Been an active member for the Sons in tribute. My father and grandfather, Vietnam veteran and World War II veteran. So their veterans are part of the Sons of the American Legion. We did the Flaxman Veterans Island over at Ford Square over the last 6 years now. Very importantly, you know, looking back on this city, we get a little bit into, and I'm going to open up for a Q&A. We've done a few of these candidate nights, so it's the 10-minute spiel and then getting into what's going on in the city. I've presently been out for the last 5 months knocking on doors throughout the city, and in a consensus, I've been hearing about your concerns about what's going on in the city today. Compiling data over the last 4 years of what's been going on in the city and how can we make it better. The bottom line for me is to make sure that our city is a safe neighborhood to raise a family, a safe neighborhood for our citizens, that our taxpayers are getting the best possible dollar for what you're doing for the city. But there is a balance that you have to strike with that. Everybody wants low taxes, but if you want low taxes, you have to also consider that the services are a little bit lower. So you have to strike that balance up at the city council level. Do we have the correct services? And do we have low taxes? And you have to strike the balance of the two. The three most important things that I like to consider when I make decisions up there is education is always going to be number one. And that's education in our Quincy Public Schools. That's education out there for our opioid epidemic that's out there. Secondly, is always going to be public safety. Public safety is very important to me. Our police, our fire, giving them the proper funding and resources to do their job. Sometimes the budget is not enough. We have to go into a capital improvement plan. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about it because we have a little bit more time here tonight. Our capital improvement plan, we are in a double A plus rating right now, which means we kind of have to bond. We kind of have to borrow funding for some of the things that we want to do in the city. And we've done a lot of different things already with our capital improvement plan, and we look to see more of it. But I don't know if the patriot ledger here tonight. Sometimes the Patriot Ledger is a little misleading when they don't give you the factual information up front. Sometimes the leading story says bonding $80 million and they don't specifically tell you what that $80 million is for or how it's being funded. A better paper, nothing against the Patriot Ledger, is the Read at Quincy Sun. Give you facts about what's going on in the city of Quincy. It's a little more accurate for you. And they won't mislead you into the direction that some of the folks have been hearing out there. I think that's very important to understand. Thirdly, which is very important, is our infrastructure improvements. As we're developing in our city, I want to make sure that we're doing smart development. Redeveloping our city, but doing smart development in it. And our infrastructure is kind of paying a little bit of the price of our overdevelopment, basically, in a nutshell. I want to, in the next 2 years, bar getting reelected, we need to work on the commercial-based real estate. The commercial-based real estate will offset our taxes for our homeowners, for our original taxpayer in the city. We're in that phase right now with the boom. I feel that we're going to be going into that phase primarily for funding for our budget, funding for our roads, funding for infrastructure improvements. We're a very old city, and underneath, when you start to rip up some of the streets, you realize that underneath, there's a lot of water and gas and sewer that we kind of have to maintain throughout the city. I'm looking to get into a different tier of doing a 5, 10, 15-year segment of what's going on in the city underneath. I want to get into a little bit more what Florida's been doing, where they've been actually buying different positioning on the streets based on the infrastructure work underneath. I like that concept. If you're looking to put a business right over there, and there needs a lot of work or infrastructure improvements to be over there, maybe that's a great way of saying, well, you're going to be a little more taxed over there to take this acquisition, because underneath you have to do more infrastructure improvement. More like a mitigation plan. You want to lease, you want to buy certain areas of our land, but you need to start getting into our mitigation of traffic, mitigation of our roads, mitigation of our street repairs, which is also our sidewalks. I'm looking in the next phase down the road for the city of Quincy. It's not just today, it's also looking for the future. As we're developing, we have to have a plan in place for the future. That's also with our children. We get back to the Quincy Public Schools. In 2010, we built the Quincy High School, 2013, Central Middle School, and now we're getting to Sterling Middle School, should be open about September, October of next year. It's three new schools in the last 8 years. I was part of the Sterling Middle School Building Committee before I left the school committee. So I'm very proud that new structure will be for our kids over in that city. It also alleviates from 340 students, it'll go to 430. So it'll be 90 more students will be able to go to Sterling Middle School. We're also in the works of acquisitioning the St. Mary's Elementary School. The kids over in behind the highway over on Grove Street in that section of West Quincy, they're all district to this school, Montclair. It's a long ways to get over here from that section. That St. Mary's will alleviate some of the congestion with a little more redistricting. Talking a little bit more on the school committee level, but it also reflects what's going on at the city council level, because funding's involved with all this. So we're looking ahead for schools, education, public safety. We've got to continue as our city grows. We have to find out ways to fund more police officers and more fire. We also need to find more ways to enforce some of the rules out there. And what I mean by that is parking rules. Tonight was a little different. I'm going to get into some of the issues tonight. Some of the issues that I want to get into is the enforcement of parking, the overnight parking that's happening throughout the city that I hear at every single door in certain sections of the city. There's a problem outside. I can't park my vehicle. There's only so many parking spots in my parking lot. I get out to the on-street parking and I can't get a parking spot at night. Well, that's a problem. That's something that we as a city council needs to also go hand in hand with the mayor and the administration to do that. So we know the checks and balances of the city, but we can also dictate a lot of what's going on in the city at our council meetings. I've been doing that. I've been your voice. I've talked about a lot of issues that are occurring and are happening right now as our city is growing. We're in that tier phase of a lot of redevelopment happening. We obviously have a lot of question marks with North Quincy revitalization of the T. We have Wollaston, we have the downtown development that's happening as well. There's a lot of concern in the city today. While I was knocking on doors 4 years ago, it's a little different feel out there than it is today. My job as a city council, at-large councilor, is to view your opinions throughout the city. An at-large council has to take together all the different pockets of the neighborhoods and what the situation is. And the top tier thing that I continuously hear across the city in every neighborhood association that I go to is traffic. Traffic is by far the number one thing that I constantly hear. Roads is number two. Roads is number two. Those are two things that go hand in hand. We need to fund our roads and we need to mitigate our traffic. I'm looking to push forward on a new traffic study as well as hiring junior traffic engineers now to mitigate some of the traffic that's going on today. These are the issues that are here. So let's find solutions to do them. I'm trying to give you a solution to some of the madness out there in the city today. I have to provide the best possible way, I've got 30 seconds, of doing that. Today, I'll talk a little bit more about the questions and the concerns out in the city. I have a little bit of time left. I just want to say that I'm continuously out there in the public eye. I'm never just showing up at election time. I'm always out there, involved in the city, at the neighborhood associations, at the PTO meetings, at the different fall festivals, and being out there in the public eye to answer anything you have. I also hold office hours every month inside City Hall. With that being said, I'm out of time. All I ask from all of you is ask for one of three votes on September 12th. Thank you.